everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. The time for talk is over as we are just mere moments away from the Super Bowl. Two teams now have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Patriots going up against the Falcons. So the time has come. Let's send you out to the stadium and join the two men that will have the Super Bowl call. Here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
All right, thanks, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas at NRG Stadium in Houston. We count down to kickoff in what should be an epic one here between the New England Patriots and the Atlanta Falcons. Alongside my good friend Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. We are honored to be here for the biggest spectacle in sports, the Super Bowl. Are you ready, partner?
I am more than ready, and I love the word you used. Honored, because it is an honor to be here. It's a privilege to be here. My excitement is just about to burst through the booth. I can't wait to do this.
Well, and sitting with both of these teams and talking in the meetings and media day and all the hoopla that goes into this, there was one common theme. They're ready to stop the talking and start playing football.
Yeah, they were probably ready a while ago. Now they can just focus on it. It's done. The only talking they have to worry about now is post-game, and they hope that they'll be talking as the winning team.
And we'll see. You know, both sides come in with a game plan to start. We'll see how the adjustments are made throughout, because there are always adjustments in this game.
I want to see if they come out conservative, trying to minimize errors, or if they have enough confidence to attack early and try and take advantage of the other team's nervousness.
We begin the next half century of Super Bowls to a strobe of flashes. Super Bowl 51 from Houston is underway. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And time to see what the Atlanta Falcons can do on offense. There's Matt Ryan, starting quarterback, just shy of 5,000 yards in that incredible season in 2016 for Matt Ryan. You look forward, he's going to be working with a new offensive coordinator, Charles.
One of the things I've always admired about Matt Ryan is his ability to embrace change, because he had the same type of a system, changed some coordinators earlier in his career, but the system was essentially the same for most of his career. And then he had a coordinator change in 2015 and had to adapt to a new style. And he did it so well that by 2016, he's the NFL MVP. So a new offensive coordinator is not going to change much for him. He's going to try to adapt one more time to a new style, new ways of doing things, and I think he'll do it very successfully.
On second down, Freeman. And not a whole lot doing there, as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Calling about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up. All right, let's look at the offense. Devontae Freeman, this is a guy that you wanted to talk about, so take it away.
Brandon, have you seen a running back play with such joy as well as such fury? I love the way he runs the football and attacks defenses.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 7. On 3rd down, Ryan. And that is incomplete. He was hoping to get that one to Tevin Coleman in space. Now 4th down. So on 4th down, the Falcons will call on Matt Bosher to punt it away. Back deep, Danny Amendola for New England. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Patriots will have great starting position as they take over 1st and 10. And bringing the Patriots out, Tom Brady. And Tom, now the second youngest and second oldest quarterback to win a Super Bowl after winning it this past season. Going to turn 40 on August 3rd. How much does he have left in the tank?
I would say that the tank seems like it's darn near full. And I can't believe I'm actually saying that, because no one is supposed to be playing at that type of a level at that.
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Now, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
And when you watch Devontae Freeman run the football, you can almost close your eyes and hear him running the football, can't you? Because people just scatter. I mean, you know, when he goes through a pile, it moves in a positive direction for him. I just love how hard he plays the game.
1,000-yard season. He had 11 touchdowns last year. In March, 25 years old. So he's kind of hitting that sweet spot for a running back, isn't he?
He really is. And I still remember the evaluation of him coming out of college. He does everything well, but you weren't sure he had a dominant trait. Well, wrong about that. He's dominant just about everything he does. And I think that he's going to continue to elevate his game and seek a third Pro Bowl in 2017.
And incomplete here on third down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Oh, it's a wobbler here. And what a golden break here. This ball is going to be touched down, but just outside of the red zone. Okay, partners, New England comes out here to take the field on offense. This is such an interesting story, how they've been able to do it year after year after year. Guys talk about parity in the NFL. Well, New England has kind of transcended that parity, and they've done it with guys that you don't normally think of as household names.
The parts keep changing for New England. That's the amazing part on offense, all right? Offensive linemen change, receivers change, running backs change. We know the one constant is Tom Brady, and that's a huge deal for them. But to be able to do it in what you call the parity times, and you're exactly right, everyone's supposed to be pretty equal. New England still a top 10 offense year in and year out. In 2016, they were number four, and that helped them with a number one ranked defense as well.
Now Brady throwing on second down. As a man, and it's Edelman for the Patriot touchdown. Julian Edelman from 4 yards out. And the Pats have taken the early lead. And when a Hail Mary is completed for a touchdown pass like that, I think any defensive coordinator just puts their face right into their hands.
I don't think there's any doubt about it. And I don't have stats in front of me. I don't have the empirical numbers that say that in recent years, the Hail Mary pass has been completed more than it has been. But it feels that way, doesn't it? And I know the defenses are spending more time on it. I think the biggest mistake they make is that they play everything from behind the receiver. I think they've got to start getting people in front as well to try and knock the ball away.
Gostkowski now, after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And making their way back out there. Second down now, this defense sort of finding themselves with their backs against the wall. Ball in the red zone. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. He lost four there, and it's third down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
From the gun on third down, Ryan. And the This is going to be incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. And fourth down coming up. The Falcons will call on Matt Bryant for the field goal try. From the left hash, this from 37. And it's picked up by the Patriots. Patriot offense, they're in the red zone. Let's get back to the action. One receiver left, three to the right. Brady, that is caught inside the five. And all the way down inside the five to the four. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. He can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. Chris Hogan from 4 yards out. And the Patriots add on to their lead. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game.
Now he'll throw with Brady. Gronkowski's got it on the crossing route. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. Gronkowski may have had to miss the Super Bowl with the injury, but he was active in that parade, and now he's back on the field. And I'll tell you what, something you mentioned to me is that he was a big cheerleader for his teammates, never hung his head through the injury, celebrated with him all the way through the title.
We've seen superstars in the past when their team does well without them. They're happy, but they recede into the background, right? They get out of the way because it does hurt them a little bit. They do have pride. They want to feel like, hey, without me, they may take a little bit of a step back. But with Gronk, you never saw that. You saw him with him every step of the way, cheering his team on, happy for their success. They went 11-0 without him in 2016. But I know this, they don't want to try it again.
No,
they want the big fella back.
And the Falcons now making their way back out onto the field. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue.
Julio Jones all alone. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones, an 80-yard touchdown. Well, the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. And Charles, I had an offensive coordinator tell me one time that they designed every play to score. I don't know how true that is, but he had to run a long way after that catch. Heck of a play.
I think that when he was telling you that, he was designing run after catch in every play.
I mean, that's the only way to put it in there, and that's what we got on that one. Nice catch, an even better run for big yardage.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. extra point try for Gostkowski. And with that, the lead is up to 8. Plays there on that drive, and it ends with a New England touchdown. Gostkowski now converted for 3. Now he'll kick this one away. See what this defense can do here. Ball at the 18-yard line in the red zone. From the red zone now, here's Ryan on first down. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. Throw again. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
And he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. And that is incomplete. He was looking for Mohamed Sanu there. And it's now 4th and 3.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
And it's picked up by the Patriots. Now here's the Falcons defense getting set to go again. Tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. The safety, Patrick Chung, is the one who makes the stop.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Here's Matt Bosher now, as he's on to punt for the 4th time tonight. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. So a change of possession here on the punt, and the Patriots take over. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. Midfield, here's Brady. And Gronkowski's got it, complete over the middle. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
Brandon, with the way things are going with Tom Brady finding Gronk as many times as he has in this game and the team is winning, you think at some point maybe even Brady would do the Gronk dance?
Well, if he does that Gronk dance, Davis, that means you have to do that Gronk dance.
Trust me, partner, no one wants to see me do the Gronk dance.
You're right.
No one.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Ah, yes, Brady to Gronk. You think these two are in sync?
Without a doubt. And look, they both understand what they can do for each other. Gronk knows if he gets open, the ball's going to be there. And Tom Brady knows what a great security blanket Gronk is. When all else fails, you find Big 87.
12 yards on the pickup, and it'll be first down, New England.
We always hear from coaches how much they like to run crossing routes because they want to hit their receivers on the go, get them the ball, and keep them moving. How about when you hit a tight end that way?
Okay. And he's going to get into the end zone. So cue up the Gronk spike. It's a Patriot touchdown. Rob Gronkowski, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. The point after try for Gronkowski. And the lead is up to 15 now. So that drive, 4 plays, and it's finished off by a Pats touchdown. Gronkowski now, after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The New England defense gearing up to take the field. They'll be hoping to come up with that same type of effort they had last time when they forced the punt that led to a touchdown.
And that type of effort just continues to carry over, because once you get it done once, you feel like you can do it again and again. It's no guarantee, but you got to like the confidence that they take back out into the field.
Now, will they keep that confidence? Time to find out. Noel, you mind if we go off topic for a second?
No, let's
you know
go.
I like to do that
let's
randomly.
Do
AFC playoff contenders for this year that didn't make it last season. Who do you have that might get in?
Well, I think Cincinnati's got to be considered there. Maybe they'd have an offseason that's calm, and they go into this season and try and get back to the playoffs where they've been perennials. How about Denver?
Yeah.
Remember last year, they didn't have the quarterback to start. Trevor Siemian played pretty well overall, but maybe they can get solidified there. And
so now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. On first and 10, here's Brady. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Danny Amendola, the man he was trying to get it to. Little lull in the action here to go over an offseason storyline. It's kind of interesting. L.A. a couple years ago, they have no teams, and now they're going to have 2 with the move from San Diego to L.A. What does that mean for the league and for the Chargers?
It seems like an easier transition, doesn't it, than St. Louis when they moved back to Los Angeles?
Less culture shock.
Less culture shock, less, you know, obviously geography, the whole deal. But it's a transition that still is not going to be easy. Remember, they're going to go play in a soccer stadium, essentially, for at least the first couple of years before they share a stadium with the Rams. So that changes things. Obviously, trying to create an identity in the market they haven't been in a long time. They began as the Los Angeles Chargers, but only played 1 season as such.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. Julian Edelman, the intended receiver, and that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, 3rd quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall. And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Brady again here on second and 10. Over the middle, it's Amendola. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the...
Back now here on EA Sports. We get set for the fourth quarter. Patriots have the lead. They also have the football. Blunt, the lone running back. Throwing now is Brady. This is caught. Gronkowski. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead. Confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish. The strap.
And that's caught by Gronk for a Pats touchdown. Rob Gronkowski with his third touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Patriots add on to their lead. They had the lead in the fourth, but still passing. Finding the big target for the touchdown. Now that lead grows. You into the start of this next possession. The score, 7-0. Throwing on first down is Brady. Oh, he got position on him and he pulls it in. It's a pickup of 14 there, and it'll give the Patriots a first down. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Blunt, the lone running back. Now Brady, over the middle, and it's incomplete. The new acquisition, Martellus Bennett, the intended target. Third down here.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. Throwing is Brady on third down, and he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down. Here's Ryan Allen now, as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart, and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Brady now on first down. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Brady will try again on second down. Over the middle, Julian Edelman, it's complete. And all the way in, touchdown, New England. Julian Edelman, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Gostkowski now, after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. So the Patriots coming out now. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good. So they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense. And they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. Over the middle, that's caught by Hogan. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they can do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold. When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Brady again here on second and 10. And right side caught Hogan. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. 2 minutes to go in Super Bowl 51 from Houston. We're back to crown a champion after this. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Brady now on first down and almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Brady gonna throw here. And he comes back with one complete. And he's gonna get this inside the 30. 12 yards there as they move the chains. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too. Yeah,
everyone dialed in. Again, they'll throw with Brady. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. The wideout, Chris Hogan, the intended receiver. And it'll bring up third down. Here comes the eighth play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. Throwing is Brady on third down. And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down.
I know ultimately that feels like a good defensive play, but I know it's really not. They had a chance to keep points off the board. Now they have a chance to kick a field goal by missing that shot.
Yeah, especially at this spot in the field. He's got to be upset he couldn't come up with that INT. So it's three more points, and that widens things out even further here in the fourth.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the three whenever you can.
Gostkowski now converted for three. Now he'll kick this one away. Offense gets ready to head back onto the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's
make
get out
of
here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Ryan connects with Sanu right side. And he's going to be taken down deep into Patriot territory. A big play there on the catch and run. 61 yards. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. From the red zone now, here's Ryan on first down. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. And that right there will set them back a bit on the offensive holding penalty.
And you know who you want to pressure after a penalty like that? The guy who just committed the foul. You want to see if he's going to keep his head down or if he's going to get his head right back into the game. I'd send a blitz at him right away and see if he holds up.
Now it's Ryan. He was looking for his tight end, Jacob Tammy, there. That'll bring up second down.
Oh, man, for him to be that.
Patriots. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I've never met an offensive coach.
Rob Gronkowski, there he goes. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Rob Gronkowski with a record fourth Super Bowl touchdown tonight. And the Patriots add on to their lead.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. They certainly made quick work of that, ultra quick work. One of the fastest drives. And when this moment comes, I think you look back at all the blood, sweat, and tears, the offseason, the workouts, training camp, week one, two, three, all building up now to say you're a Super Bowl champion. It's worth it.
It certainly is, and rarely do we have a team that hoists a Lombardi trophy that didn't have their share of bumps along the way, didn't have to face some adversity in the journey. And now they get to just enjoy it and revel in it. And all offseason, they'll be signing their autographs with Super Bowl champion underneath it.
The Super Bowl champs, the Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.